21 rebounds, 5 blocks,
to brush our
4
hair.
Steals, and above all, Minnesota 83, Sacramento 82.
This is Jolie at her baby naming. Finally taking a nap just when the rabbi comes. Not very helpful.
Wait, they left?
You have Alicia, right? Yeah, you have.
Just go play.
Or Yoella, which one?
You can keep talking, it's okay. We're not. We're good. Over there, I'll tell you what. Okay, you guys go there. No, you're fine right over there. Just move this a bit.
Want to sit down?
Okay. Pretty formal, right? She's the formal one here, I'm not, right? Now, before we're going to begin, you know what we're going to need? Either two sticks or one match. Or a lighter.
A lighter, that's true.
Little Boy Scout humor.
Mom was thinking about that.
Excuse me, is that kosher?
Can't you tell it's been circumcised? All right, and speaking of circumcision, in a sense, that's what we're doing here. As many of you know, what we're doing today is, in a sense, we are celebrating Jolie's bris, but because bris really does not mean circumcision. Okay, no, don't worry. Bris is the Hebrew word that means covenant. And for a baby boy, we are told early on in the Torah, in the book of Genesis, that we welcome him into the covenant of the Jewish people by circumcising him on the eighth day of his life, if he's ready. You remember, Robert. But for a girl, we welcome the little girl with a very special ceremony because it's just as important for the little girls to be welcomed into the Jewish people and that ancient covenant that began with Abraham and Sarah some 3,800 years ago. And one of the wonderful things is they can, unlike becoming a bar or a bat mitzvah, one can be welcomed into the covenant while they are sound asleep. So, this is a good thing. Hello. Okay. You think she's going to walk like that?
Yes, she does.
She's got off the horse.
That would be from your side.
Yeah.
Thanks, Bob.
Anyhow, it's a very joyous occasion, and that's why we're gathered together on this beautiful day. We are getting ready to celebrate, speaking of covenant, a very, very important Jewish holiday. It begins in just a little bit more than 48 hours, called Shavuot. Some of you may know it as Shavuos. And this is the anniversary of the date when God gave Moses, according to Jewish tradition, the Torah and the Ten Commandments. And that was, of course, the central event, other than the initial act of Abraham having to circumcise himself. That was really the central
Hey-o.
Event. Yeah. that one, I mean, it's bad enough to watch the Moyle do it, but to do it yourself. But in any case, that really is the central event in Jewish history, talking about the covenant between God and the Jewish people. God gave the Torah, and the people of Israel accepted it. And what we're doing today is Rob and Susie are bringing their lovely little girl before family and friends and reciting traditional prayers and formally welcoming her into the Jewish people. And as part of this occasion, we're also going to be giving Jolie Rachel a Hebrew name. And what we're really going to do is we're going to give her two. And many Jewish people have two names. How many people here have two Hebrew names? Anybody?
Right.
Have two. Okay. And it really relates very much to the holiday that's coming up, Shavuot, because some of you may know that when Moses went up to Mount Sinai and God said, I'm going to give you the tablets of the law, and Moses asked, how much are they? And God said that they're free. And Moses said, I'll take two. So Jolie has invited some of her favorite people here today. And we're going to share the ceremony with you. Oh, and even if there's some injuries and chaos in the background, that's okay, because we have to focus on what we have to do. And Jolie should be a role model to all of us. She is blissfully unaware and undeterred, because she wants to be formally welcomed into the Jewish people. So we're going to do that right now. All right? Now, the first thing we're going to do is I'm going to take this.
This biblical. This,
though, actually, these are wonderful for lighting barbecues.
That's what we use it for.
Yes, for any of you who've ever tried to stick a match
right.
up there. Yeah.
That's right.
No, so these are great. And what we're going to do is we are going to light this one candle. Okay, two on Friday nights or on holidays. Well, we're going to light this one candle because in the Torah, in the very beginning of the book of Genesis, it says that God created light as the very first act of creation. And light is a symbol for Jewish people, and really for people of most religions, of God. And we pray that God is always going to be part of Jolie Rachel's life, watching over her and her parents and her grandparents and the whole family, and blessing them with all kinds of good things. And you know, one of the blessings that I understand Jolie has already brought to her parents is lots of sleep, which I, you know, as soon as Susie told me about this baby, I said, don't tell anybody that she sleeps like that, they'll hate you. It's a very, as the father of four, I can tell you, this is quite a blessing, a very unusual thing, so. Fortunately, mine sleep through the night now, but they're a little bit older. So anyhow, so we pray that the light of God's presence will always be part of Jolie's life, and that her life will be a long life and a healthy life. As we say in Yiddish, some of you may know, bis 120,
right.
Okay, or in Hebrew, ad meyav esrim, that she should live to be 120, all right? And the grandparents will all be there for the 120th birthday party, right, to celebrate. And why 120? Does anybody know? Okay, that was quick. Okay, somebody very famous in Jewish history lived to be 120, and that was Moses, okay? He's the one who went up onto the mountain, and for those of you who are, have you hit 59 yet?
Not yet.
Not yet, but one year.
Okay. Reverse the digits and you got it. Yeah.
Thanks, Steve.
Well,
that's right, sure, I know it, that's right.
Well, what you need to know is Moses didn't even get started until he was 80. So you can accomplish a lot of wonderful things.
He's a late bloomer.
So we're going to begin with our ceremony, which I think most of you have copies of. If not, we have some here. Good. Oh God, our Creator, happy parents have come into your presence today to voice the longings of their hearts in prayer. Give them the wisdom to teach their child to be faithful to the heritage of the household of Israel, that she may grow up with the knowledge that you are always near to her, guiding and sustaining her. Keep open the eyes of her spirit, that she may ever be conscious of the beauty and wonder of your world. And let her learn to love the goodness that is in man and woman, that she may ever nourish the goodness that has been implanted within her. Though none of us can fully escape sorrow and pain, we humbly ask for Jolie the courage to face evil, the faith to transcend it, and the strength to subdue it. Grant her health of mind and strength of body, that she may enjoy fullness of years and live to do your will in faithfulness. And together we say,
Amen.
See, everybody's following along. Very good. Good. She's going to check and make sure I don't make any mistakes in Hebrew. All right. And now, before Susie and Rob say a very special blessing, I'm going to say a blessing which is special, but not quite as special as theirs. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Gomel Chasadim Tovim. And if you would all say, Amen. Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord our God, ruler of the universe, whose love and kindness extend to all the world. We're saying Amen. It's okay. Right. Sounds a little different for dogs. Right. It's all right. Now, in Jewish tradition, we are told that ideally, we have the time, we're supposed to say 100 blessings every day. Okay? There are blessings, obviously, over the food. There's a blessing maybe when you see a rainbow. There's even a blessing, and the kids always laugh about this, and you may as well, but there's even a blessing when you successfully go to the bathroom, okay? Because, yeah, well, yeah, but it doesn't happen, it's, you know, okay. So, see what you have to look forward to.
You have plenty of blessings.
Susie says a blessing when Rob changes the diaper. Right, so we have all these wonderful things going on, and the blessing that they're now going to say is called the Shehechianu, the blessing for the most special of occasions. We say it for the first night of Hanukkah, for the first Passover Seder, and said it your wedding day, and all these other wonderful times. So I'm going to ask you guys to lead us in that.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, shehechianu v'kiyamanu v'higianu lazman hazeh.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord our God, ruler of the universe, for giving us life, for sustaining us, and for enabling us to reach this happy day. O God, for the gift of this child, we give thanks, praying that we will be worthy of the blessing and responsibility of parenthood. May we show our gratitude to you by leading our daughter in the way of righteousness. Help us to guide and instruct her, that she may grow up to be a proud, knowledgeable, and active member of the Jewish community.
I think we can all say amen to that, right?
Amen.
We agree with that. Mi sheberach avotenu Abraham Yitzchak v'Yaakov, ve'imotenu Sarah Rivka Leah v'Rachel, hu yivarech et hayalda hazot, hakadosh baruch hu yishmerecha, v'yate et leib hayalda, lalechet v'darche yosher, v'hi Adonai ima, v'yitein la deya bina v'haskel, chayim v'chesed, bracha v'shalom, v'yizku avotecha l'gadlach u'lechanchach, the Torah, the Chupa, Ulama'asim Tovim, Benomar, Amen. You're getting good at this. May God, who blessed our matriarchs, Sarah, Rebecca, Leah, and Rachel, bless this child with long life and excellent health. May she be a joy to her parents, Susie and Rob, and may she be a joy to her grandparents, Francine and Donald, and Susan and Howard. Have them stand up. A little round of applause here. Yeah. And I think you deserve that. And a joy and a blessing to the entire family. May her life bring honor to the Jewish people, blessing to humanity, and glory to the name of God. And now, in the presence of all the loved ones who are gathered here, we give to this beautiful baby, and of course, any sleeping baby is beautiful, baby. But this one, we're going to give to this beautiful child the name Yoelit Rachel, Bat, daughter of Reuven Abba and Sarah Rivka. May it become a name honored and respected for wisdom and good deeds. May God's blessing rest upon this child now and always. Now, of course, when we name a baby, we name after and recall family members who are departed, but this particular name as well recalls two very important people in the Bible. Yoelit actually is the female version of the name Joel, which in the Bible is one of the prophets. Okay, one of the 39 books of the Jewish Bible is the book of Joel. Now, most people are kind of surprised to hear that because we think Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, and Joel. But truly, it is there, and it's a fairly short book. And one of the other things that's very important about that book is that we read from Joel on the Sabbath between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, what is called the holiest Sabbath of the year. It's called Shabbat Shuva, the Sabbath of Repentance. So Joel is a very important book of the Bible, and the name Yoelit certainly recalls Yoel in Hebrew. And of course, Rachel was beloved, and the woman that in the Bible Jacob worked for 7 years in order to marry, and then got tricked a little bit and ended up having to work another 7 years to marry her, but she was worth it, and he never complained. So we pray that this name will be honored and respected for wisdom and good deeds. We pray that God's blessing will rest upon Jolie, Rachel, Yoelit, Rachel, now and always. And what we're going to do is we're going to now say a blessing, which I think most of you know, because I've explained this, I think, to most of you before, but just in case you don't know. We're going to say a very traditional blessing that goes back to the time of the Tana Vilecha, V'yaseim Lecha Shalom, May God's presence be lifted up upon you, Yoelit Rachel, and may God fill you.